Controlling a player. This is probably the most fundamental part of any game that you have played. But how exactly can a computer with its logic and control make such a trivial thing work? Well, to answer that question, we are going to find out by trying to control one using SFML and C++. This video will also help if you are struggling in controlling an entity or any kind of object on SFML. So let's start. The first step is to make a header class called Entity. Then in the public side, we will create two functions, the constructor and the drawTo function. And the private is the actual player we want to control. Now note that it doesn't have to be a rectangle shape. In this method, you can control any type of SFML objects that are transformable. Now, in the constructor, we set a parameter for the rectangle and set the size of it. And in the drawTo function, we add a window reference to the function and draw the rectangle to it. You can use pointers instead of references, but in my opinion, references are cleaner and much nicer. Now that we have a rectangle drawn on the screen, it was trying to control it. But first, before we code, we need to know how this all works. Basically, there's an entity in the screen, and what we want is to change its position when a certain button is pressed. SFML makes this easier by what is called events. Events are, well, events that happen on the window. To put it simply, if a button is pressed, that is an event. If a window is closed, that is an event. And if a mouse is pressed, that is also an event. That is what basically an event is. Now we can use this event to control the position of an entity. So in the class, we create two void functions, processEvent and updateFunction. The processEvent will take in two parameters, the sfKeyboardKey function and the boolean check pressed variable. And we also need to create four boolean variables that indicate the press of the buttons we desire. On the process function, we add an if statement that checks if the boolean check pressed returns true. If that is true, we'll add another if statement that checks if the button like W is pressed. And if that is true, we change the value from up to true. We do this for down, left, right boolean values. If all of that is not true, we change all the booleans to false. After that, in the update function, we initialize a struct called vector2f. Vector2f is just a struct that contains two float variables, the x value and the y value. Then, based on the boolean value we processed on the processEvent function, we assign the struct based on the boolean value, and then we use the move function to the struct value we changed. And on the main poll event while loop, we check if the keyboard is pressed. If so, we're going to enter the parameter of the key we entered and set it to true. And if the event type is released, we enter the parameter of the key and set the second one to false. Now if we compile the program, it works. We can control a player on SFML. That is basically it. That's how we can control a player on SFML. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.